Tăng thì Thảo Vi là 2. Ok. Any questions? No, ok, good. Chúng ta đã... I mean, we have finished the first half of the semester, and from this week on, Miss Hien will change to another way of learning vocabulary and grammar, and hopefully you will find this more effective. So let's move on to the first one, which is vocabulary. Let's review the nouns. Yeah. So there are four nouns that you really need to know when we talk about topic psychology. First one is predator. Predator. Second one is survival. Survivor. Okay. Survival. Capability. Capability. Illusion. Okay. Now let's read the words, Miss Thuy An.
Predator, survival, capability, illusion.
Now number three, capability, and number four, illusion. Illusion, illusion. Thank you, please.
Predator, survival, capability, illusions.
Yeah. Do you know some examples of predators?
Predator, C1, 2, survival, B2, 3, capability, 4, illusion.
Ủa, bạn dùng app gì mà đọc hay vậy? Hả? Có mọi nghe một giọng đàn ông nào để đọc giọng 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 mấy từ trên đây luôn. Mà các bạn dùng app gì vậy? Now what answer? All right, so now let's move on to the verbs. We have lots of verbs here. And we'll go one by one. So the first one is adapt. Adapt. We say we have to adapt ourselves with the new situation, or when we move to a new environment, we have to adapt. We have to learn how to adapt. Next one is a hard word to spell. Is camouflage. 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 Okay. Mimic. Oh, camouflage can be a verb. It can also be a noun. Mimic, which means to copy, okay? Resemble. Next one, distract. Six, enhance. Seven, manipulate. Eight, utilize. And number nine is deceive. Okay, now someone, let's say the words. Hoàng Duy, please.
Yes, adapt, camouflage, mimic, resemble, distract, enhance, manipulate, utilize, deceive.
Thank you. Thùy Duyên, please.
Yes. Adapt, camouflage, mimic, resemble, distract, enhance, manipulate, utilize, deceive.
Yin, read again. Camouflage. Camouflage. Camouflage.
Camouflage.
Yes. Number six, enhance.
Enhance.
Number seven, manipulate.
Manipulate.
Good. Thank you. Now, which words are still difficult for you to use? Jean, which one is still new to you? You are not confident with it?
I don't know.
Which word is still hard for you to use? Do you know?
Many play seven.
Mm. Manipulate. Manipulate is a verb, which means like when you ask somebody to do something, and then you get the benefit from that activity. So you want a guy to do something because you want to take advantage from that activity. Yeah. So you manipulate someone. Mình lợi dụng ai đó thì mình dùng động từ manipulate. Okay. Thùy Dương, please, can you read the words?
Yes. Adapt. Camouflage. Mimic. Resemble. Distract. Enhance. Manipulate. Utilize. Deceive.
Good. Is there any new word for you?
For me, the new word is camouflage.
Oh, yeah. Have you ever seen any animal that changes its color depending on the color of the surrounding environment?
Yes.
Yes. So we call that animal, we call that phenomenon is camouflage. Okay, we change the color to match the environment. Okay, or in other words, we say disguise. Okay. Thank you. Let's move on to adjectives. We have three hard adjectives. Virtual, objective, and infinite. I want to hear from Miss Thanh Hà.
Yes. Virtual, objective, infinite.
Thank you. Okay, so I would think that you have learned these words. So now let's come to an activity. There will be two teams, and I will divide your class into team gentlemen and team ladies. Okay, so then each team has a set of questions and 2 minutes to play. So we will play team by team. Yeah, you listen to the questions from your teacher and then you shout out your answer. So if all the guys know the answer, please unmute yourself and then shout out the answer. If your answer is correct and you pronounce the word correctly, and then your team get 1 star. If correct answer but incorrect pronunciation, you are one of the star is taken away. If you have no answer, you got 0 star, 0 point. And then wrong answer, you will be -1 star. Okay. And remember, the losers. If your team loses this game, you have to turn on your cameras during the lesson. Like if team ladies loses, so then all of the ladies have to turn on their cameras during the lesson and vice versa. Everybody, do you understand the rules?
Yes.
Are you ready to go?
Yes.
Yes, ready.
Okay,
ready. So, let's go. So, which team goes first?
Ladies go first.
Ladies first. Okay, ladies. This is, here are your questions. You have 2 minutes, okay? And if any of you knows the answer, please unmute your microphone and shout out the answers. Okay. So 2 minutes, go. First question, what verb means to adjust or change to suit conditions?
Adapt.
Adapt. Good. Question 2. Can you spell the word camouflage? Các bạn nam theo dõi giùm cô à. Các bạn đội này trả lời đúng mấy câu nhé. Nam, can you spell the word camouflage?
C-A.
Please.
C-A-M-O-U-F-L-A-G-E.
Yes, that's right. Question 3. What adjective means endless?
Infinite.
Yes, infinite. Question 4. Which verb means to make somebody believe something that is not true?
Deceive.
Good, deceive, right. Number 5. It's dangerous to use a cell phone while driving because it can ... you and you might not notice other cars or people. Any answer?
Distract.
Distract. Yes, good. Question 6. This noun begins with letter C and it is a synonym of ability or skill.
Capability.
Sorry?
Capability.
Capability. Good. Number 7. This is a synonym of the verb to be or imitate.
Mimic.
Mimic. Good. And question 8. This noun refers to an animal that hunts hunt other animals for food.
Predator.
Sorry?
Predator.
I heard a lot of versions.
Predator.
Yeah, predator. Thank you. And, oops, sorry. How many correct answers do they get? Camouflage, correct. The word predator, some incorrect pronunciation, but you know, one of the girls pronounces correctly. So, team ladies, congratulations with 8 correct answers. Yeah, now team gentlemen, here are your questions. Are you ready, gentlemen?
Yes.
Yes. Are you ready to lose? So let's go. This verb has the same meaning with to improve.
Enhance.
Enhance. Good. Question 2. This noun means to have false impression of something.
Illusion.
Good. This noun means the ability to continue living.
Survival.
Good. 4. Can you spell the word eye deceiving?
D-E-C-E-I-V-E.
Again.
D-E-C-E-I-V-E. I-V-E.
But my word is I deceiving, not deceiving, okay? So you missed the first half. Question five. This verb means to handle or use skillfully to manage or control a person again. Again.
Manipulate.
Sorry?
Manipulate.
Manipulate. Thank you. Question six. Can visual deception be ... for good purpose, or it is always intended to play a trick on others to have an advantage over them?
Utilized.
Utilized. Okay, good. Question seven. In addition to using colors for camouflage, some animals usually naturally the shape of a rock or a leaf so they can hide very well in their environment.
Mimic. Mimic.
Mimic. Mimic. Actually, the word is resemble. Question eight. This is an adjective, which means to be unbiased or not subjective.
Objective.
Objective. Congratulations. And you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 correct answer. So it means that who wins the game? Congratulations, team ladies. Yeah, I'm sorry for the gentlemen. So gentlemen, please turn on your camera during the lesson. Yeah, this is a punishment, and all of the gentlemen, please turn on your camera. We will continue. Okay, I just need to text. Yeah, I'm so sorry because I'm not sorry. I'm happy to see your faces the first time. So I will count how many gentlemen in this class. And the ladies, please help me control. If one of the guys turn off the camera, please call his name. Okay. I will count. Check. Can you help me check, Mr. One, Phúc Thịnh already. Two, Khánh Tài. Khánh Tài, where are you?
I'm here, miss.
Turn on your camera. Three, Vinh Quang, right. Four, Thiên Phú. Where are you, Phú? Các bạn nữ control giùm cô nha, thấy anh nào mà gọi tên. 5, Trần Nhiên, already. 6, Trương Nhật, yes. 7, Duy Nhân. Duy Nhân, where are you?
Em có mở nãy giờ mà.
Rất là nhiều hot boy quá. 8, Phan Thị Ngọc. Phan Thị Ngọc. Các bạn nữ check kìm cô anh nào chưa có. Oh, yeah, I see Ngọc. 9, Đào Nhật Minh. Yeah, I see him. Lê Gia Huy, number 10. Got it. Đức Huy, most talkative guy. Nào, already. And Hoàng Duy. Okay. Các bạn nữ ơi, con thiếu anh nào không? Đọc tên coi. Khánh Tài. I don't see you. Ok, I see you now. Right. Các bạn bật bật cam như vậy ha cho tới cuối giờ. You look great. Yeah. Okay, let's move on to the next part of the lesson today. So, we review the vocabulary, and I hope you can use some of these words. Now let's move on to grammar. So today we learn about the relative clause. Wow, I look great with this background. Okay, so the relative clause, including the use of which, whom, that, and who, in sentences. And I am not going to explain the theory, don't worry. So please join this game, everyone. Chat box. We will join a game. And then you try to finish the questions. Ai là ngoại đạo? Okay, let's join the link. And then I will get the 0.5 for the two fastest, two best players in this game. So click on that and then answer 10 questions. If you are finished, please chat. Please type done in the chat box. One, two, three, four, five, 11. Please tap done if you have finished. I see three students finished. Xin quên xong rồi, xin quên nhìn giùm cô xem còn vắng bạn nào chưa bật cam. Có 14 bạn nam lận. Yeah. Okay, yeah, so let's see. So the fastest student. Nguyên cũng để sai hai câu à. Nhật đúng hết. Anh Nhật ha, để cộng điểm chính là anh Nhật nè. Thứ hai, người thứ hai, yeah, anh Nhật đúng, tốt. Next one is Huy. You made two mistakes. Yes. It's four. Two mistakes. So I would give the plus four. Trời, Xuân Hào thì khỏi điểm luôn, sai 4 câu lận. Miss Quỳnh, Nguyễn Thị Quỳnh, you get plus from me. Yes, all of the correct answer. Như vậy là mình có hai quả điểm cộng, đấy là bạn Nhật và bạn Quỳnh. Thank you. Now, please tell me the answer. Thảo Vy absent. Quỳnh Trang, please. Number one, read the whole sentence.
Alexander Fleming, who discovered penicillin, received the Nobel Prize in 1945.
Trang đọc lại cho đàng hoàng cả câu cho trôi chảy quá. Trang.
Yeah. Alexander Fleming, who discovered penicillin, received the Nobel Prize in 1945.
Yeah, penicillin. Thank you. Number two, Anh Thư.
The book which I need can't be found in the library.
Thank you. The book which I need. Em nhớ ngắt câu cho nó đúng nhá. The book which I need can't be found. Thank you. Next question, Miss Nguyễn Ngọc, Anh Thư.
Em mới trả lời nãy rồi.
Miss Trần Trúc, Anh Thư. Trần Trúc, Anh Thư, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Please.
Which hear me the best? The sentence swimmers.
Okay, can you say the sentence again more fluently?
I'm hearing the beach. Which is the sentence for swimmers?
Thank you. Nô Phước Thịnh. Alo, Trần Phước Thịnh.
Yes.
Please.
Do you know the American woman whose name is Margaret Mitchell?
Yeah, whose name? Thank you. Lan Thi.
Yes, miss. Jim, whom I had known 14 years in one of my closest friends.
Thank you. Next, John found a cat. Khánh Tài, please.
See.
Can you read the whole sentence?
John found a cat whose leg was broken.
Yeah. Nguyễn Quỳnh, please.
Cô là em ạ?
À? Yes.
Yeah. Don't sit on the chair. The leg of quick is broken.
Thank you. Xuân Quyên, please.
Câu là this tree whose branches are dry should be cut down.
Thank you. Vinh Quang, please.
Yeah. The child smiled at the woman whom he didn't know.
Thank you. Chị Phương, please.
Yes, miss. That woman whose name I don't remember is the daughter.
Thank you. Thank you very much, everyone. So this one is kind of easy for you, right? So let's move on to the next part. I want to make sure if all the gentlemen is now are turning on the camera. So let's move on to the first activity. Today we will talk about social media, and the first activity will be pair work. So you will be put in breakout room, and in each room there are two students, and you will be there in 20 minutes. You will ask and answer the questions given on the list. Tell the class if you both share the same idea or different. So I mean, after 20 minutes, when you are back to the main session, I will invite you to share if you have this, you two have the same ideas on all the topic, all the questions or not. Okay. So here are six questions to be asked. First is, how many social networking sites are you using? Can you name them? For example, Mr. Huy and Ms. Hien are in room one, and Huy asked me, how many social networking sites are you using, Ms. Hien? And then I will answer, well, I'm currently using Facebook. And then I will ask back, and what about you, Huy? How many are you using? Okay, so if two of you share the same answer, you put a tick. Okay, but if you have different views, please note it down so that I will call you to report that to the whole class later. Question two, have you ever tried to find a soulmate on social media social networking site? And do you think it was dangerous? Question three, what do you think of putting personal information on Facebook? Explain why you think so. Question four, what are the best things of social networking sites? So let's talk about the benefits of social networking sites. Question five are about the dangers. Okay, question six would be, do you think that social networking sites will make people lonelier? And explain why you think so. You can, I will take a snapshot of this slide and then I will send in the chat box. So listen. Miss Hien will visit, Miss Hien will join your room. Okay, and when I visit your room, and I will be there in 1 or 2 minutes. And then if when I'm joining your room, and if I hear nobody speaking, if I don't hear anyone speaking, so two of you will receive a punishment. So I promise the punishment will be serious. So the thing is, try to speak. Some weeks ago, when I joined some of the breakout rooms, and then students said nothing, all of them kept silent. So if that situation happens again, so if I visit your room and then no one is talking, both of you will receive a punishment. So do you have any questions before we go into the rooms? Any questions, please ask. Two students in a room. So how many students are in the classroom now? And I want all of you to turn on your camera when you are talking. 40, chưa đầy 20 phòng nhé. 20 rooms. 39, cho nên là cô sẽ có một phòng sẽ có 3 người. Okay, you have 20 minutes, ask and answer. Please go to your room now.
Là 6 câu trong 20 phút luôn hả? Vậy là một người hỏi lần 6 câu luôn hay là hỏi từng câu? Dạ, ông hỏi trước hay tôi hỏi trước? On my style, I usually use the YouTube, YouTube networking. Đúng không? So, okay. So, YouTube. I use to. Have you ever tried to find your soulmate on a social networking site? And was it dangerous? I have the same idea with you. I think when I try to find your soulmate on my social networking like such as Facebook or Instagram, it's maybe not dangerous with me because I don't share a lot of information. I'm very careful when I share information about my soulmate or my or the person who I'm talking. Yes. Cái đó là tôi nói tôi kém vui thôi. And explain why huh? And by my side I think putting my informations on Facebook or Instagram or Yellow It's a little dangerous because this is my private proficiency. So the administrator can use my personal information to do some training about some to somebody or something, and it will bring tiếng xấu nói sao sao mà nó tiếng xấu á, mày tiếng xấu cho tôi á, hoặc là cái thông tin của tôi đi làm cái điều gì khác đó. Tiếng xấu nói sao ta? So how about you? Khó chịu hả? Uncomfortable. Mang mang tiếng xấu là bad reputation. Dùng cái từ deceive được á. Deceive administrator will deceive other people by information, by my information, by my personal information, nghĩa là lừa gạt người khác bằng cái gì ta, thông tin cá nhân của mình đó. So the next question is, what are the best things of social networking sites such as Facebook, Twitter and Instagram? That is a nice answer. So for me, I choose Instagram as Instagram because Instagram don't have dialogue informations, and it makes me feel comfortable when I screen on and find something something new on Instagram. And it are very different of Facebook. Facebook may had in had in use thing. Tool had is your platform. So I like Instagram. Cái hồi nãy tôi tìm được cái từ gọi là dialect information, là thông tin loãng á. Trên Facebook thường nó thông tin loãng hơn. Dialect. D-I-L-U-T-E. Caption bật đâu. Ba. Ok rồi đấy. Dial part đó hả? Hay là để thấy ta CC. Ta mở đúng không ta? Thân thấy đang là slab. Thấy rồi. What the hell, tiếng gì cả ông nội. Tôi không biết gì hết. Rồi tí. Rồi ta tắt đi cái. Ủa cái này chỉnh tiếng Việt rồi à? Ok. Nói đi. Quên. Từ. So, quên ông nói chứ quên. By the way, I see it. Networking site hiding a lot of dangerous things. Like the bad guy will see picture or information of you on social networking site, and they can find you or use your private informations to act something like deceiving your family or neighbor, your friend, or some etc. So how about you? What do you think? Honestly, I think the more people using, the more people use social media, the more they feel lonely. Because when they use, when they spend a lot of time for social networking, they will less talking about, talking direct to the real persons, real guy or real guy. And dần dần có chịu ta. And from that they, and from that, from that for a long time they can talk fluency or naturally with not to another people, like such as your such as their friend or school or their girl who they very who they crush on your school. It's my idea. Vũng Tàu City. Social networking. Right. Thì mình nói bị bắt thì cái này mình dùng đã cho thấy vẫn dùng ít mấy cái từ C1 quá ha. Cái từ nãy mình học chưa xài được. Còn networking với lại social social media là giống nhau mà. Social networking site, social networking site với lại social media giống nhau mà. Đúng không? Okay, cũng vậy.
Okay, welcome back everyone. Let's wait for some other students on the way back. So now I'm going to ask some of the students to report. So we have talked about social media, and I want to ask your opinion of question number 2. So, Thien Phu, do you and your partner share the same opinion on this question?
The answer is yes, we both share the same opinion because social, when you meet a stranger on the internet, you don't know what is their personality, so it's dangerous to find someone that's faithful and trustworthy on social media, and you have a chance of getting deceived or tricked into doing something dangerous.
That's
so we
great.
Both think that it's not good, it's dangerous.
But the thing is, have you ever tried?
No.
Not yet, okay. I'm so happy when you can use the word deceived, okay. You can even use the word virtual. And virtual, or where you can even use some other words. Thank you. I would like to ask from Miss Anker, Nguyễn Ngọc Anker. So question three, do you and your partner share the same opinion?
I think I would think date, yes. Lemon juice is in your Facebook because I want to everyone know the birthday, so everyone congratulations from me.
And what about your partner?
Oh, partner. Sorry, I forgot. Partner.
You forgot? Oh my God! So you are not a good partner. You didn't pay attention to your partner's opinion. It's not partner. Really. So, Trương Nhật, I want to hear from you. So, do you and your partner share the same opinion? Question three.
Can you rephrase the question?
So, when discussing, and do you and your partner have the same opinion for question three?
Well, I and my partner also have the same opinion in question three. From my perspective, it's not necessary to post any information from myself into Facebook or Instagram or something like that, because it's very risk to be posted by hacker, people who have bad purpose.
Yeah. So you think it's very risky, right?
It's very not risky. A problem if you just put general information, including name or phone number.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay. I want to ask another one. Miss Ngọc Nhi, Dương Ngọc Nhi. Nhi, do you and your friend share the same answer for question six?
Yes. Me and my partner, we have the same idea.
Same idea. So what are your ideas?
Yes. We think that socialness with side make people lonelier.
Lonelier.
Because when we
isolated in the real world if we just look for a brand in the Facebook.
So you mentioned about the isolation, right? Isolate and isolation. Thank you. Okay. So let's move on to the next activity. You have just prepared the ideas for the next activity, everyone. So we will come up with a debate session. So I will start sharing. So we are going to have a debate between the female's ideas and the male's ideas. So the topic is about social media, and I am going to show the question in a few seconds. But I want to give some instructions first, and I want you to be very clear of how to do this. So there are two teams. So one of the team will be agreeing with the statement. I mean, one of the group will answer yes. Okay, and you will find some arguments, some ideas to defend your point. And the other team will be against. So your answer would be no. So you will also give your statements, your ideas, and try to defend your idea. Okay, so here are the steps. First, you have some time to analyze the topic and then choose your stand, whether you agree or disagree. Then you will listen to the argument from your opponent. Then after listening, you have to counter the argument. You have to say, maybe you are right, but I do believe this. Or you can say, that is a good point, but do you think this and that? Okay, and then go back to team one. You have to defend your argument. Try to defend that argument, okay? And so here are some ethics. First, when you are participating in a debate, I want all of you to state the facts. You can Google to find some facts. Do not just give your personal opinion. Expect by saying something like, that is a good point, but, okay, or I understand what you say, but you say, maybe you are right, however. So those expressions show your respect to your opponents. And then remember to speak, don't shout, okay? When your friend is talking, please do not interrupt. And the main purpose of this debate is to have fun and to learn something from your friends. So don't take it serious, okay? My question is, today we will debate about Facebook. And the question is, does the world need Facebook or not? Does the world need Facebook or not? So ladies, would you choose yes or no? Ladies? Do you think that the world needs Facebook or not? So I let you choose the side first. Would you say yes? Team ladies?
We say yes.
Okay. You say yes. So you have to try to find the arguments to defend your opinion that yes, Facebook is inevitable, okay? It's important. We cannot live without Facebook. Things like that. Try to give the bright side, the benefits of Facebook. So focus on the strongest benefits, strongest opinion. So gentlemen, you would defend for the ideas that the world doesn't need Facebook. everything will be fine with Facebook, without Facebook, I mean. So try to find the strongest point. Yeah. So all of you, we have 5 minutes to get ready. 5 minutes to find the facts, maybe. 5 minutes to prepare what to say. And then we will have the debate. Okay. Every time you speak, please introduce your name. And if I see that you have got good ideas, I will give you plus. Okay.
Cô sẽ có điểm cộng cho các bạn có phần là tranh luận tốt nhé. Cho nên khi bạn bắt đầu thảo luận sẽ là my name is hoặc là I am. Đó. Và chúng ta sẽ show your respect by okay, you, maybe you are right, but we think this or that. Okay. 5 minutes to prepare the ideas. Khánh Tài, which team do you want to belong to? You can choose. I let you choose.
Con trai á cô.
I mean, you can choose to say yes or no. I respect. Okay, 5 minutes. Huy, stop chatting. Are you chatting with Tai?
No, I find some information on the internet.
Yeah, some interesting. Yeah, that's why I see you laughing, smiling. Mình sẽ đi từng point, từng ý và mỗi một ý khi mà bên kia không cãi được nữa thì chứng tỏ bên kia thua. Để cho mình phải bảo vệ ý kiến của mình tới cùng. Ok, và các ý kiến các em đưa ra là ngắn gọn và súc tích. Và cái luận cứ đó nó phải thật mạnh mẽ để bên kia không cãi được. Kết thúc một ý rồi mình mới chuyển qua ý mới. Okay, let's get started. And I will let team leading to give the statement first. Why do you think that the world needs Facebook? Team lady? Let's go away.
Yeah. Angela, don't go.
Please, anyone. You belong to one team.
Okay. So, since we use social network like Facebook, we can connect with many people like friends or relative far away and connect with many people anywhere. I think so.
Yeah. So Miss Đặng thì Quỳnh Trang said that we need Facebook because it is a good tool for us to get connected with people all over the world. Gentlemen, please counter this argument. Ten. Nine.
Yes. Can I?
Yeah, sure.
Yes. You know that there are plenty of platform that could provide that function. Why we have to need that need Facebook? Why we have a plenty of platform?
Yes.
Have the similar function like Facebook, and it's the dictionary campus define the word needs is that must have. If you say something you don't need something, that it means that you don't want it because it causes your trouble.
Yes.
You know, and we don't get any trouble if we don't installing the Facebook app. Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes. So let me summarize. Mr. Thing said that there are 20 other apps that can connect you with the world. Why? Why Facebook? Without Facebook, we still have another app. Team ladies, how do you defend? Ten, nine, eight, seven, six.
I think Facebook best apps in this.
Can I?
Yeah, let's go. Five, four, three, two, one, zero. So. For the first round, team gentleman wins. Okay. So, so ý thứ nhất chúng ta đã kết thúc rồi. So the girl said that it is a great tool that connects you and the world. But team gentleman said that without Facebook, we still have lots of other apps which can function this. Okay, I agree. Now it's your turn, team gentlemen. You go first. You start with a statement. Why we don't need Facebook?
I will answer these questions. Facebook. The usage of Facebook can decrease our motivation because when we see such a rich people or the people more beautiful or richer than us, our self-esteem hurt a lot because we try so many ways and cannot be like them. So it can decrease our motivation a lot.
Oh, yeah. Do you understand this argument, ladies? It's a good point. So we said that using Facebook can decrease our motivation in life. For example, when someone posted, when someone show off their rich life, okay, blissful things, beautiful things, so we will feel envious, jealous. So ladies, you try to counter that argument.
Oh, thank you for your idea, but why do you think that you can decrease your motivation, but when you look at a better version, better than you, you can create a motivation to try hard to be like them. I think they are the ideal model for you to imitate or to become in the future.
Yeah, good point. Yes, gentlemen.
You say that we have models on Facebook to follow, but nowadays Facebook feeds you with so many useless information. The advertisement is fill up your new feed, so it's a hard way to find the right model for you to follow or the useful information for you. I think so.
No, excuse me, Huy, you misunderstood. So Ms. Thu said that. So why do we have to envy their you know, rich people? We may see them, oh, they are rich, they are beautiful. We can admire, then we can imitate and try to be like them. Mm-hmm. So instead of feeling envious or jealous, we should feel, you know, admirable. Yeah? Any guys want to counter?
I will start the conversation.
Yeah, please.
For my opinion, Facebook give us many, keep posting like people who getting billions of money a month. That can affect on other people's behavior, make them feel useless. They will beginning to lose their life, and they start to be the useless person for the society.
Mm. Yeah. So, ladies. So Mr. Yahui suggested an example, like a lot of young bosses posted, you know, they are very successful with luxurious cars and villas. And then when we read those new feeds, we have feeling, oh, we are useless. We have nothing. We may compare ourselves with them, so we will lose our living motivation. Yeah, ladies, you want to counter this argument? 10?
I think that everything have the benefits and detrimental aspects, like the fact that when I surfing my Facebook newsfeed, I watch some makeup videos and I can learn a lot from them. So I can do it by myself and improve. Enhance my makeup skill to make me more beautiful.
Excuse me, Thảo Nhi, we are focusing on the idea that Mr. Huy raised, that we Facebook can decrease our, you know, living motivation. Do you have any ideas to counter those arguments? Otherwise, you will lose. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Yes. Please. I think, well, as of the statistics show that as of the 2020s, Facebook claimed 2.8 billion monthly active users and ranked 7th in global internet usage. It was the most downloaded mobile app on the 2010.
Yeah.
And to do that, Facebook is the most popular social networking site in the world, and I'm sure you yourself, and I'm sure you yourself are using it every day, and this is a way to spend the financial amount I think is necessary for promotion and development.
Excuse me, but let's focus on the idea that Facebook really decreases our motivation in life. If you have no other point, you will lose. Ladies, I keep counting. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So sorry, team ladies, you lose again. Okay, so the second, the world doesn't need Facebook because it really decreases our motivation in life. Now, team ladies, you give the second point. Now, why we need Facebook? Give the second benefit of Facebook. Now you can restate your benefit. Who can? Ladies, please give another benefit of Facebook that persuade the gentleman to use it.
Facebook can be accessed from devices with the internet connectivity, such as personal computers, tablets, and smartphones.
So what does it mean? Remember, lady. Yeah, Link, keep talking.
I think is a benefit that can be accessed from device with the internet connectivity.
So they said that Facebook is accessible. Yeah, it's easy to access everywhere, every time. So what does it bring? What does this benefit bring to us? Okay, gentlemen, can you counter this argument? They said that Facebook is accessible. You only need a device with internet connected. Internet connection, I mean.
Can I answer this question?
Sure, yeah.
You say it's easy to accessible, so a 4-year-old kid can have an access to it and post their personal information like their address or their school or their hobby, so bad people can manipulate and kidnap them when they get back home from school or somewhere they are going to play. That's my answer.
Excellent. So ladies, please defend your point. because Facebook is too easy to access. So any kids can access it. You know, kids cannot control their behavior. So they may easily share their information. So bad people may manipulate that situation and kidnap the kids. Yeah, ladies, please protect your ideas. Every student, every girl in this class, you can unmute yourself and protect your group's idea. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, zero. Sorry, team lady, you lose again. So it's very likely that the world doesn't need Facebook. So Facebook will may disappear. It doesn't matter. Now, the last point, team gentlemen, why Facebook is not necessary to us?
Yes, I have opinion, miss. So I can give an example that I have seen an item on Shopee or Google yesterday. Then immediately I can see it on Facebook. So
what does it mean? What does it mean?
It can be said that Facebook is following user secretly and not respect private demand of user.
Yes. Yes. So, ladies, do you understand his point? So, Mr. Nhat means that Facebook steals all of our personal information and they are following us secretly. But the thing is, they use our personal information for commercial purposes. Please, you protect. And Yad gave an example of, you know, he searched for something on Shopee. And then suddenly he see some ads on Facebook related to the items he wants to buy. Ladies, let's defend your choice.
Yes, I think it's necessary because it's not the current needs you are looking for and you can refer to it.
So what does it mean? So do you think that it is not dangerous?
Yes, I think it's just the marketing strategy because this theory that everything is very simple, but people make it complicated.
People make it complicated. Okay. <Yeah. laughs> Okay, what do you think? Yeah, Ms. Nhi said that, yeah, it's fine. They are using it just for marketing or for marketing strategies. And it.
Yes, but do you have any evidence that proves that a company don't use it in the wrong purpose? How could we know that?
Yeah. Because we didn't have anything to lose, I think.
Yeah, we have nothing to lose.
Not just you. We talk about the world. And so some the user have important information, you know. They could Yeah.
Like celebrities, right?
Yes. You don't know. You don't have any evidence to prove that, I think.
You know that your address can be shown in the world, but it doesn't mean that everyone can go on come into your house or break your privacy.
Yeah.
I think you misunderstand in here. This, we talk about private information that we commit when we sign up Facebook account. We have a confirm about the
policies.
Yeah, the policy, right? That they could use our information, but we don't know they could access in our information in our device. They could use a lot of information not about in Facebook, but out of Facebook, you know, and that could be dangerous. And we don't know that they could do anything to us.
Okay. Sorry, but can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Yes. 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 Sure.
Do you use Facebook?
Yeah. Oh, please do not ask that question because we are, you know, trying to protect the point. Okay.
Yes.
Yi, continue.
I think it's not that negative, because if you can ensure that your secret information not be shown in any social media.
But the thing is, when you register or when you sign up for an account on Facebook, you have to provide them with your name, your phone number, and then your ID card, etc. So once you step into Facebook, they collect your personal information. And he means that we don't know what they use our personal information for. And one day, Thảo Nhi becomes a celebrity, and then they may hack your, you know, account.
Yes, but I think it's a general information and you don't have to make it
complicated.
Yes.
Yeah, gentlemen, she said that, okay, those are just very general pieces of information.
Maybe you are right. However, some personal information, your personal information that can be affect to you, but them can hide about information about your work as that can affect to your work as
Everybody, please go back to Mr. Nhật's idea. Nhật said that Facebook can, you know, follow us secretly, and then they will know what we need, and then they will feed us, and then they will use that for commercial purposes. So that is the initial point. You have to focus on that. Don't go too far away. So ladies, I just see you didn't protect your ideas very well. Quynh, you want to say something? Don't be scared of these faces. They are the losers, so they have to turn on cameras. Why are you scaring them? Các bạn nữ sao hôm nay yếu thế thế các em? Mình thua hết hả? Thua hết cả ba ý rồi. Thế vậy tóm lại là chúng ta không cần Facebook. Because of three reasons. First, Mr. Huy said that it can decrease our motivation in life. Then another idea said that it is dangerous for kids because Facebook is very accessible. Okay. And the next reason is Facebook owners do not respect clients' privacy. So our personal information is stolen and we don't know what they use our personal information for. So the girls cannot give any persuasive ideas to persuade that we need Facebook. I'm sorry, the girls. Today you lose. So in the next week, next class, you are the people who turn on your camera. All of the girls. Okay. I record it so I will remember. Thank you everyone for participating in a very productive lesson today. Although the girls were quite silent, they didn't go as well as I expected. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this lesson. So we still have some minutes before we end the session. So do you have any questions for the exam? You have any question for the exam? The midterm test, I mean. No. Các bạn không có thắc mắc gì về đề thi giữa kỳ đúng không ạ? Các nhóm đã sẵn sàng rồi ha. Hôm sau các em vào team ấy thì các em có thể gọi là phòng thi số 1 này. Rồi, thì các em tí nữa cô Hiền sẽ gửi qua nhóm Zalo cho các bạn là những nhóm nào thì thi ở phòng số 1. Thì khi mà đến giờ thi ấy, thì các em cứ vào phòng số 1 nhé. Rồi các em sẽ thuyết trình và thuyết trình xong thì các em sẽ là đi ra ha. Chúng ta có 3 phòng thi và 3 giảm thi khác thi. Ok. Thì cô sẽ đưa cho các em cái danh sách thứ tự thuyết trình và sau đấy là cái giờ mà các em cần có mặt. Ok. Yeah, thank you everyone and goodbye for now.
Goodbye, miss.
Goodbye, miss. Thank you, miss.
Goodbye.
See you, miss.